You know how Fox is a weird way of counting Simpsons episodes? They refuse to count a couple of them, making amount of episodes inconstant. The reason of this is the lost episode from season 1. Finding details about this episode is difficult. No one is working on the show at times. No one likes to talk about it. From what has been pieced together, the last episode is written entirely by Matt Groening. During production of his first season, Matt started acting strangely. He was very quiet, seemed nervous and morbid. Mentioning this to anyone who was present results in getting very angry and forbidding you never ever mention it to Matt. I first heard of it at an event where David Silverman was speaking. Someone in the crowd asked the episode. The Silverman simply left the stage, ending the presentation hours early. The episode's production number was 7G06. The title was Dead Bart. The episode labeled 7G06 Moaning Lisa was later given Dead Bart's production code and hide in the latter's existence. In addition to getting any angry, asking anyone who was on the show will cause them to do anything they can stop you from directly communicating with Matt Groening. At a fan event, I managed to follow him after he spoke to the crowd. He eventually had the chance to talk to him alone as he was leaving the building. He didn't seem upset that I followed him. He probably expected a typical encounter with an excessive fan. When I mentioned the last episode though, the color drained from his face and he started trembling. What if I ask him? He could tell me any details. He sounded like he'd been on the verge of tears. He grabbed a piece of paper, wrote something on it, and he handed it to me, begged me not to mention the episode again. The piece of paper had a website address on it. I would rather say it was for reasons you would see in a second. I entered the address in my browser and I came to a site that was completely black, except for a line of yellow text and a downloaded link. I clicked on it and a file started downloading. Once the file was downloaded, my computer went crazy. It was the worst virus I ever seen. The system didn't restore, it didn't work. The entire computer had been rebooted. Before doing this though, I copied the file into a CD. I tried to open it on my now empty computer, and I suspected there was an episode of Simpsons on it. The episode played off like any episode, but it had poor quality animation. If you've seen the original animation from the Enchanted Evening, it was similar but less stable. The first act fairly normal, but the way the characters acted was a little off. Homer seemed angrier, Marge was depressed, Lisa was obnoxious, Bart seemed to have a genie anger and hearted for his parents. The episode about Simpsons going on a plane trip near the first act, the plane was kicking up, Bart was fooling around, as you expect. However, the plane was 50 feet off the ground. Bart broke a window on the plane and was sucked out. At the beginning of the story, Matt had an idea that animated style of Simpsons the world was representing life. The death of things turned more realistic. This was Lucy's episode. The picture of was barely recognizable. They took advantage of having a movie and making photorealistic drawing about this.
It smells like eggs over there.
The shot.
There's no
Bart
dead
when Act 2 started, Homer, Marge, Lisa were sitting at their table crying. Crying went on and on as it more pain and sound realistic. Better acting than you would think possible. Animation started to decay and more. As they cried, they would hear mumbling in the background. Characters barely made it out. They were stretching, blurring. They looked like they formed shadows in the random bright colors thrown on them. There were faces looking in the window. No one flashing in the and out, and so you would never sure what they look like. This crime went on all for Act 2. Act 3 opened a title card that said, the title card saying 1 year had passed.
How?
Homer, Marge, Lisa were skeletonly thin and sitting at the table. There was no one inside of Maggie or the pets. They decided to visit Bart's grave. Springfield was completely deserted, and they walked to the cemetery. The houses became more desperate. They looked at abandoned. They look all abandoned. When they got to the grave, Bart's body was lying in front of his tombstone, looking just like it just did at end of Act 1. The family started crying again. They eventually stopped and stared at Bart's body. The camera zoomed in on Homer's face. According to his summaries, Homer here tells a joke at this part, but it's not audible. That I saw in the version I saw, you cannot tell what Homer is saying. The view zoomed in as the episode came close. Tombstones in the background had been backgrounds of names of every Simpsons guest star on them. No, some of them that no one had heard of it in 1989. Some that haven't heard on the show yet, all of them kind of deaf dates on them. Guess who died since? Like Michael Jackson, George Harrison, when they would die. When credits were completely silent and they had written, the final image was shown on the Simpsons on the top, like intros, but the hyper-realistic lifeless of Bart's corpse. A thought occurred to me after the episode, they would see tombstones to the death living Simpsons guest stars, but there's something more odd about it. And then most of the ones who hadn't died yet. All the deaths were listed at the same date.